Hello, everyone, and welcome to Transformers UK show. On today's show, we've got loads and loads of news to go through. We've got Nathan here. He's going to talk about his customs. We're going to preview the Netflix trailer, which will be awesome. We've got those pickups to go through, and I will start off by welcoming my host. So, Alexis, hello.
I'm well. I'm good. I thought we were a podcast.
No, we're a show now. It's a show.
Officially a show. We've got
I can't afford audio beam.
Jamie,
how are you, Jamie? Hello.
I am fantastic, Paul. Thank you very much for asking.
Music to my ears. Andy, how are you?
I'm wonderful. Thank you for asking.
Brilliant. And Nathan, thank you for joining us today.
I haven't eaten sweets, so I want it. I'm eating.
No, that's fine. You eat away. We can see some of your customs there in the background, and we'll have a good look at them later. But we'll start with the news. I'll go straight into a Sherry screen.
I jog some TV, and now the news. Don't touch that dial.
A bit of Legends. You should be able to see Thunderbolt there by Mech Fans Toys. So this completes their lineup of three triple changers. So they've already done Octane and whatever the other one was, Astro Train. And this is the third one. What do you guys think?
I think it's amazing how they've actually managed to get three decent modes better than Hasbro have ever attempted at, and two masterpiece, dare I say. I haven't had Ditka, but I've got Gawalt. So I just think the way that he poses and stuff, it might be a trick of the camera, but he just looks, apart from the big fold there in his tank tracks, he looks really good.
Yeah, his tank mode looks better than DX9's tank mode, I thought. He hasn't got that big bit at the front. It's probably a mock-up, isn't it? It's not it's probably CGI, but have you got Astro Train? You haven't got Astro Train, have you?
I haven't bought any just yet. I've got DX Nungle, but I do need to invest in these. These are on my wish list, so I keep a little tag on the items on eBay, and every now and then I just look at how many are left, and so far there's plus 10, so I'm okay.
Of course, he is nice, the Astro Train one.
But for 30 quid as well, right? Like, so, yeah, around that sort of price, 25.
Yeah. I think it's sub £25.
It's a lot of bot free modes.
It is.
That's £8 a mode.
And Octane's not out yet. I can't remember what he's called, but he's still not released. Astral Train Team. Oh, nice. So that boy is not released, but I'll be getting him. And I guess this is going to be the third one to come out. So that's cool for you, Legends fans, and continuing the Legends love. We've got Newage news. Well,
is this Golden Lagoon sort of homage?
Yeah, it's that kind of homage, isn't it? And it's they do like repainting their figures, Newage, don't they? They spend a lot of R&D, I guess, about making these really strong, excellent figures, and then they just change the colour all the time.
They've done this with all of them. They've done a Megatron, they've done a Starscream, which I think you've got the Starscream, haven't you, Paul? Coming to you. Yeah. And then this is their Chimera as well. So they're having this whole sort of like Goldfinger or, you know, who's the sort of like Austin Powers Goldmember style entourage, aren't they?
Yeah, it's more. It must be bigger in Japan. This is a Japanese thing, isn't it? The Gold Lagoon, Golden Lagoon figures. We've seen.
Takara and Ace are doing a lot of things like that, haven't they? Doing abstract and random things from Transformers cartoon episodes.
They had the Year of the Horse, didn't they? Before where everyone was sort of see through, and now as you said, it's Golden Lagoon style.
I can't not look at that and just think GPS over and over again, even though I know that I'm sure they've solved that problem, but it just reminds me of the GPS.
GPS?
Global Positioning Satellite.
Yeah, the gold plastic syndrome. Come on, what do you say with us here? Gold plastic syndrome and the amount of G1 figures that just crumble when you touch them now.
They flake, don't they?
I'm sure it's not a problem now. I'm sure they've righted whatever that issue was, but I just look at it and that's the first thought.
Nathan, we've got you on the show.
I still want to see the back of that camera mode because I'm just going to laugh because you can see their faces.
Yeah, you can see the top of their heads.
I imagine their faces are laughing back at us as well. Imagine their faces are laughing back at us. Well, Nathan, is there a particular paint or colour that for you that is always tricky, that always flakes, you find? Is gold trickier than other colours?
No, gold's easy. Hardest two paints for me is yellow and white. Yellow is a very, very, very tricky paint. Gold I've never had a problem with. Never.
He's very gold, so he should be fairly resilient with the new paints. Next up is Transformers Earth Rise RC, so we've spoken about her a lot. there she looks cool, I think. So all the photos have her with her backpack on. This is with her backpack off. I would say that's just as good as Generations. What would you guys think?
Yeah, I quite like it.
I like the improvements, but I still don't like the idea that the entire back half of it is a quote-unquote surfboard or something.
Isn't the G1RC anyway just a bit of a problem because of the design? The design wasn't the cartoon. Well, this is the cartoon design, which is what everybody tries to base it off. What just isn't practical for turning it into what it needs to turn into.
But why either sacrifice the robot mode to get the car mode right, or you do vice versa.
Yeah,
it's like with the Legends one or Generations one. I still think that's the best looking one, but everyone moans about the chest is too square and it sticks out quite a bit. What it does.
I think the Legends Takara version is pretty much spot on for me. I think they've done a superb job.
The Legends Takara one is good, but I do like the look of this one.
The improvement
on Nathan's screen there, that does look, I don't know if it's just the way that it mocks up, the colours on yours, Nathan, look better.
It's because it's the Takara one, it's more animation correct.
Yeah.
But I will say one good improvement about that version is she has a waist swivel.
Yeah. People lost their heads about this, though.
That you can see. Oh, I hate that. I really don't like that.
What did you say, Andy?
So for the podcast listeners, that's the photo if you're looking underneath the car mode, isn't it? And they've got the Legends version, I think it is, next to the new Earthrise version. And the Earthrise version is literally just the robot with the back, with the legs folded up underneath, and then the rest of it is just a shell, isn't it? And that set people completely mad.
As people have said,
why? How many people are going to display it like that?
That's the thing. And to be honest, it's going to be easy to custom as well, because you're going to have no paint rub really in the transformation.
So I would say customs. You would actually. I'd worry about those legs, how they fold in. If you look, it taps behind some of the parts. I think that'd scrape too easily. That's come from a customizer's standpoint, like where the legs come up onto the pelvis region. My worry about that is that would start scraping on there.
I feel the same.
You're right there, Jamie. Yes. I'm just going to go AFK for 2 minutes. I apologise as I go to pay for something.
Another eBay purchase mid-show.
Jamie, stop buying stuff.
Jamie's of a shell form. I don't like how
it's very shell forming. But like Andy said, what can you do? With her really,
well, we
and Legends did do it well, but when you look at her alt mode, that's the bit I fall out with, and I haven't got it, so sorry. But just look online, the alt mode looks a bit pants to me.
I don't like the covered wheel look.
Yeah, I don't like that either. It's
not RC in my opinion.
So I think alt mode, Generations wins, but I'd say robot mode. I've now warm to her.
I will say the robot mode looks great. It's getting to the robot mode. What's the problem?
Yeah, I agree. Right, also, so this is Fans Hobby Athena, which is Minerva, and everyone is starting to get really excited about this. So the excitement began when they announced it. Yes, yeah, I'm waiting any day now.
See, I'm jealous now, because I've having seen some of the early kind of them, but I think Sixo had it with his unboxing video and transformation video, and he's written up a review, and it just looks amazing, and are they photos, toy box, soap box?
You can still get one.
These are all 6.0 photos. I'm going to show
6.0 photos. There you go. Sorry.
So if you go to www.6.0transformers.com, you can see what's a photo. He always does great photos, but these ones blow me away. And this has all come on that he got it a little bit earlier. People are starting to get theirs now.
He got a reviewer copy, didn't he, though? As if you watch the video when he does the unboxing, he says and points out that he is a reviewer. That's why he's got it early. But yeah, it looks really good. I have to admit, I wasn't as interested until I saw that.
Well, I saw the prototype.
She'd fit in your collection as well, Mr. Ride. She would.
I think we discussed this before, didn't we, Alexis? And somebody was saying that it's like masterpiece scale. But actually, looking at it, I think it fits in with Chug.
She is masterpiece scale. She's quite a small character. I'm trying to think. There was a picture of her next to. I think it was next to an RC.
Right.
I think it was. I'll see if I can take it out. I'm trying to think where it was, but there's a picture of her next to RC, and she was about the same height.
Yeah.
It might be the Generations RC.
I think it was Generations RC.
She's about the same height as Generations RC. So she's quite a small character.
I've asked Gav a couple of times, and he said, no, it's definitely going to be the size of, like, almost leader class.
Yeah. So I don't do masterpieces, but this is the figure I would be tempted to pick up, just because I love the design.
Because if it was chug size, I would have bought that.
So it's actually the reason I made my Minerva, my custom one.
Hang on. I've got the monster bots right to hand here, actually. Those monster bots. I've got one right here. So
out the cabinet.
Now they're at the bottom. At the bottom. Monster bot. There you go. Legend scale prime is 4.5 inches.
But Jamie's scale is in the eye of the beholder, so let's just...
this is a new section we do on every podcast, where Alexis just randomly grabs different lines of Transformers.
To be fair to Alexis, I think he's trying to show in that photo that you've now put on the screen, Paul, you can see the Repugnus third-party figure.
Fans.
And Hobby I'm looking for that kind of comparison.
So she's about here. She's about 6 inches, yeah. I think.
She's about Voyager size, I'd say.
She's about six inches.
She's definitely not Voyager size of a chug.
But the cool thing is, I'm really excited about this. Right. So
she's definitely leader class. Well, Alexis, you should have bought out is your Vat-Bat thing and put that next to your monster bot. Then you would have a better comparison with MC.
Nah, that's too hard to get. I already just knocked over like six Transformers on my desk.
Did you?
there was timber. There was serious timber going on.
When this was first announced, there was excitement, and it's grown and grown. And now I think there's people who went into Fans Hobby or even third party and now buying it. It's £50 as well, which for masterpieces is cheap as chips.
Well, they are.
You consider how rare the original toy is as well, because the original toy is difficult to get, isn't it? So
I never even heard of the
fans
toy.
Of that character
before.
Yeah. Yeah,
I never even knew. So I wish that was obviously free. Yeah, we obviously had the free headmasters over here, didn't we?
So this is landing this week or next week or the week after. It's landing soon. Fans Hobby has said. So expect the same. You know how at the moment every other picture on my Facebook is about Scorponok. This in the next couple of weeks, every single picture on Facebook is going to be about Athena.
What's your request, Storm? I want Paul, not Alexis. When we get this toy, I want Paul to give us a scale with a proper chug to see.
To see whether Jamie will be buying it.
Yeah,
I don't have a chug.
Something that's irrelevant. I want Paul to do it.
I will do that, Jamie, for you, definitely. But yeah, now, how many pictures of bloody Scorponok were there? Like,
millions.
Every other picture on Facebook. And it's going to happen the same with Athena when this lands. And
it's also going to happen during our podcast. But
So this was a picture which was not official, and then it turned out it was official of the upcoming Netflix. And so I think this is a good point. We're going to look at the new Netflix trailer, which came out this week. Please share instantly, co-host, if I share this without the sound. Right, so share screen. So Netflix, War for Cybertron trailer is out. Share computer sound. Here we go. So we're going to quickly play. It's not a long trailer. And then we'll talk about that.
I have done what I have to do to end this war. Honor will not win this war. The Autobot Resistance. I cannot help but ask myself, is this a hopeless crusade? Have my actions led to the extinction of our people? The Allspark is a vessel of life. In the hands of Megatron, there's no telling what he might do. The Allspark. Yes.
A clean and decisive victory.
If we can.
continue on this course, no one will be left to win.
The circle closes, Prime. You are defeated. We end this war now.
That I thought was really good.
I was quite excited because it looks like Bumblebee might die at the start. Yes.
The animation on that section with Bumblebee was really good.
No, that's the thing. It's whether the animation is a bit. I mean, it's some of that Prime Roars trilogy stuff from the Machinima got a bit better, but some of it was so clunky. It was.
Okay, it wasn't great. I don't care.
It looks better. I just want it looks better.
Yeah. I don't want the animation to speak to me. I just want to have fun and just.
No, but it needs to be half decent. It doesn't need to speak to you.
I'll be drunk while watching it, then I won't care so much. I'll be banking out. No.
I'll be watching it at 6 in the morning.
The story looks better as well. The story looks better as well. So,
yeah, no, 100% agree with Andy. That's the potential wrench would be if it's the animation is so clunky with Prime Wars.
They try and make it to like the toy, though, aren't they? They're trying to.
Yeah, exactly, Alexis. That's exactly.
But look for the eyes of the kids who might be watching this. Would they really care so much about animation? I know some people are picking out saying, "Oh, it's too toy accurate because they'll have the pegs on them, or they have this."
But what I mean, what we're trying to say is, Jay, they should make it like a no holds barred like animation, like almost like Cyberverses, so that you take all that shit out and. Then when the toy comes out, you accept the peg in that place.
Because accept you know the peg, name of your sex tape.
It's a representation of your dream figure, right? And I think as we all accept the things we buy, the things we love, because they're a representation of things that we fell in love with when we were children.
No, it's true. Watch me, Alexis.
I think it does look good, and I will watch it. I don't actually think it's. I think kids will watch it, but I don't think it's. I think the whole point is, Hasbro have said many times, that this whole Chug line is more aimed at the adult collector kind of bracket. And so I think this cartoon crosses. But I think kids will still watch it.
Kids jog on. What was better? What was better in that trailer than Prime Wars trilogy? For me, music was amazing. And what did you guys think was better?
I agree with Paul there. Music.
I agree that it made it dramatic. I thought Megatron seemed naturally quite dark as a character. I thought Prime seemed almost quite desperate. You are going to see people sacrifice it. You know, spoiler alert here if you don't want to hear this, but it looked like Magnus is going to die, and it looked like they're going to, you know, to unleash probably something like Omega Supreme. Someone's got to effectively like sacrifice.
I don't think Magnus is going to die. I think if you listen to the trailer, there's the bit with Shockwave and Megatron talking.
Maybe.
And I think the thing is, they're going to use the Allspark to basically turn Autobots to reprogram them into Decepticons, which would explain things like
Jetfire.
The Netflix Mirage and Jetfire having the Decepticon symbol, which
I think as well.
We know was G1. But,
No, you thought Ultra Magnus is going to die. We just
I agree. I still think Magnus is going to. I think Magnus will sacrifice himself as and give his spark to Omega.
He didn't look as though he was sacrificing himself. Looked as though he was getting tortured in that video.
That's the coolest I've seen Magnus look though.
I think
when he had Magnus, icon and he was walking forward.
I think he's giving him.
And the Omega Supreme claw bit was quite good.
That's going to be the ending. Obviously, it's going to be.
Yeah, I saw some people on Facebook, and there was. Obviously, lots and lots of the trailer being shared by lots of people. And after a couple of days, somebody put a comment on one of the trailers saying, "I've just realised I think that could be Omega Supreme's claw." And I just think
a revelation
after everybody else. But all right, you got there at the end.
That's like my one.
Instantly saw it.
That's what mine
Omega Supreme. I saw the same comment as well. I thought, Alexis, why are you writing that?
He's too busy talking about his male toys.
Oh,
I was going to save that. Got to love for, auto. I got, the pickups.
I've got a new phone, so it doesn't know my language yet. So Meg Toys comes out of the mail.
There is one more bit of news.
Paul, one more bit of news actually, which I can share now, which we forgot to share last week. So if I share my portion, it was this Megatron.
Oh, that does look good though.
So this was
isn't he £40 as well?
£50, I think he is. So this is off Shosie's store, but he's the is it animated?
It's Transformers Prime Megatron.
Transformers Prime Megatron. So he's Voyager class. He's about 6 and a bit inches, which is perfectly adequate if you ask any woman.
Not any women. It's been with you, but yeah.
I feel sorry for you. You're getting targeted today, sir.
That's it all, isn't it? We don't do that
today. Targeted today. I feel like I built you up. I feel like I riled you guys up over 25 previous podcasts. We've got 6 months late, half a year's worth of.
Nathan's giving us the strength.
So for our fans and our viewers, then this is on the screen. So you can see Megatron. He actually cleans up very well. You've got his sword is back there as well. Transformed into his lovely gunship. I think this would make a wonderful custom, actually, into almost like what's it called?
Thunderwing.
I don't know.
I thought Duraxis.
I thought he's a good shape for Thunderwing. Actually, you could almost take off his head.
I could do both.
Take off his head. Be like a good
Jamie. What do you think?
Duraxis.
There's one thing I would be surprised if it. Well, what's right? I would like to see him do. So have you lot seen Transformers Prime up to like the last season where the Beast Wars film they did?
Yeah.
There was a version of him as Unicron with all the masks battered off. That's never had a figure. I would love to see that like that.
Yeah, the Beast Hunters, Unicron Megatron would be cool.
Yeah, because the actual figure could for the Beast
Hunters. Custom one. Talented gentleman could create a custom one,
Nathan. The actual one. If I'm right, the actual Megatron they brought out for the Beast Hunters line was like a Piranacon version.
Yeah, it was like a Sharkticon.
Some weird
shark face on its chest, which is quite a rare figure, I think. But they never unless they did it in Japan. But I don't remember ever seeing the unicorn version.
I saw them over here.
Right.
But yeah.
Right. Cool. So let's get back to the news. There's still a few little bits to go. Shelf green. So much news. It truly is the golden age of Transformers.
It is.
Right, so this is landing on people's doorsteps at the moment, which is Kimara, isn't it? New Age Kimara.
Non-gold versions.
Yeah, so the gold version is news, and this version is landing on people's doorsteps.
I don't know about you, but this has been my most expensive month to have to pay for Transformers. It's like, I paid for some last week, and then I got another bill this week. And I was like, "Are you joking?" And then I got another bill again. I'm like, "Oh my god!" I was like, "How many freaking pre-orders are coming out like right now?" It's like everyone is like anyone who works at these companies is wanting to go on the summer holiday, and they're just landing now, aren't they? all before the second wave of lockdown with COVID, we don't know about yet. Quick, get them out! Get them out!
Get them out before our business collapses. John Toy Reviews. I wrote that using my phone. I remember doing that with my video photo editing app to say, because this guy is actually one of our own. He's a TFUK participant, and he'd done a review, and it came up on Dame Chock Reviews, Dame Chock Reports as well.
Alicon.
Prime versus Prime has literally, it's just popped up on my phone. Prime versus Prime has just put his review of the same figure up as well.
Okay.
For those who like watching him, second this time.
So we've caught him sleeping. John Toy got
that
out
looks
first.
All right, the Alicon. There's not much to the transformation, though. At least it doesn't appear to be.
I haven't seen the review. What did John say, Paul?
He said it was a fine Transformer. It was a good review. And it's simple transformation, but good detail. Paint work is really green.
Oh, it's awesome.
Doesn't he just basically stand up and turn around?
Yeah. It's what it is. It is what it is.
I haven't seen a video on it, but just looking at it, I can tell how it transforms. I'm not saying it's a bad figure, but it's one of those you can see how it's done.
The third party figure, which I've got two of, really does suck ass. It's It's worse. It's worse than sucking ass, to be honest. It's like,
well, now you have a reason to get a chug figure, then, don't you?
No, I can't. I can't. It's something
bigger.
Wait for the knockoff. Oversized one, then.
That's what she said.
Oversized. Yeah. My sex tape. Oversized KO. That'd be great.
Is that Sliverfang?
Yeah, that's Sliverfang. I think that's all we need to talk about.
There's a review of that as well on what's the guy called? He's called something like He-Man Reviews. He's an Australian reviewer. And he did a review of that that's quite
good. I quite like him, actually. He gets some good stuff, doesn't he?
It's quite funny as well, so.
I reckon I could transform that in about an hour. Easy. Easy.
You're very optimistic tonight, Alexis.
Magic Square, Megatron. So he is about to land as well. So I'm expecting Greg to ask for.
I just thought it would be that move is opened.
Yeah, the face doesn't work. For me, but the figure
extra faces. Right.
You get lots of extra faces with him. What I love, right, is they're deliberately showing the inside of his thigh, his lower leg, because you remember the New Age one, they had to swap the legs out.
Faces there.
No, there is three. There's three alternatives.
Yeah, it's the top
of the gun barrel.
Ah, right, they're facing downwards.
Yeah,
they're facing down, and they're upside, as well.
Quality.
It does look really good. I'm looking forward to that going out my wallet.
And then finally, I think this guy's for the box art for it's Yurai Shi Ma. Yep. Which is Iron Factory's Leo Convy. So I pre-ordered him. We showed him last week. He's starting to land as well. He
impressed you that much, did he?
For an Iron Factory bot. Yeah, he did. £29, £28.
To be fair, I loved his goat mode. I thought that was really
good. Goat mode was good.
Goat mode was good.
I don't have enough Transformers which could turn into goats. I noticed that the other day. I was looking at my cows, and I thought, there's a lot of Transformers turning to cows.
That's it.
Where are the goats?
Goat formers.
And this ticks.
Mutton this ticks in that disguise. Goat fetish.
I'm just trying to figure out how you say that name. I think it's Yuri Shimari.
Yeah.
I was going to say, we're not going to win any points on pronunciation. No,
it's the fact that Paul just gave up, like, I'm going to have to try and figure this out, so I'll take it myself.
I'm not too bad at Japanese, actually. I'm pointing. Right, so what's next? Before we start, I just want to do some shout-outs. So we want to say a big thank you to everyone for last week's show. The amount of people been watching has been growing and growing and growing, and it reached a new record last week. It was really cool to see. Some people have been seeing the show and then joining TFUK, which is our normal home. Let's see if I can get Facebook up and working. I could do some shout-outs now.
Got closed down Pornhub.
Yeah.
No, he doesn't close it down. He just pauses it.
That's it.
Closing that down.
He's never made it past 2 minutes, Alexis, in a porn video.
Parents, sorry again if you're watching.
They make longer ones.
Right. Okay. So shout out Gav Burgess. Not sure who he is. Benjamin Cotty. Benjamin was on the show a couple of weeks ago. Shout out to him. David Whidden, shout out to him and his two boys, which is really cool for him to say, Samuel and Matthew. It's a big shout out to Samuel and Matthew, and thanks for watching along with your dad. Matthew Davis, he said it prompted him to join the Facebook group. He likes it best when Alexis goes off on the tangent and I reel him back in. Comedy gold. Davis Thomas hasn't seen the show yet, but he commented anyway. I'll send him a link and he's going to have a watch. So welcome to the club, Davis.
Welcome, one and all. Love it.
Yeah, it's brilliant. Wayne Anthony Morgan, just 100 more to go. Wayne Anthony Morgan, really enjoyed last week. There's only a couple more. He watched last week and really enjoyed it. John Sherwin, hello, John. He's looking forward to this show, especially that Nathan's in it. John's a fellow customizer artist. And painter and artist, and he's looking forward to tonight. RJ Callahan, he's wanted a shout out. He just gets shouted out every week anyway.
We mention him every single week. He gets a shout out. Come on,
he deserves it. He's
been on the show, hasn't he? Once,
yeah, he's even been on the show. and Stuart Baxter was the final one. He's watched all the podcasts and shows over lockdown, and he's all caught up now. He loves the show, and is looking forward to tomorrow. So thanks, Stuart, and thanks for joining
us, guys.
So massive thanks to everyone over 240
thank you
views and subscribers. So thank you very much for that. Right, moving on, and it's pickups time. Who would like to go first?
I'll go first.
Cool.
I like how you put your hand up.
That's what I was about to say as well.
Yeah,
I'm going to go to the spotlight.
It's like being in my job at school. Earthrise hoist.
Ah,
boom. That's it.
What did you think? He's nice.
He's an amazing figure.
But I do really like him, and I wasn't. Overly bothered by Hoist. I kind of liked him as a kid, but I never actually knew anyone who had Hoist, the actual figure. Anyway, the kids had a load of money saved up because they've not been able to really go very far during lockdown, and we paid a very quick visit to Smith's so they could spend their saved up money.
And, how much?
£16. £16. Wow. So, but he's really nice. He's like all of these Earthrise, certainly deluxes. Most of the figures, to be honest, they're really good for what you're paying for it for $16.99. It's like, you know,
wow.
When people complain, really it always makes me laugh. It's like, what do you want here? So, like Jamie said before, it's like it really is. It does feel like a golden age of Transformers with
everything. It's shipping around.
Yeah, exactly. It really is.
How I see
fish at the Hilton.
It's a lot less risky. I don't tend to change the bots in my collections once I have them, but Earthrise is making me change all of them. I'm changing all the Datsun Brothers, I'm changing all the others. Mm-hmm. Just an amazing series.
That's right.
I think
so that's it. That's all I got this time.
What do you think about the hands?
Sorry.
So there was a bit of a criticism from myself that his hands look a bit sticky outy.
In his vehicle mode, you can notice them, but you see, again,
is it that bad?
Maybe this is a generational thing, but growing up with G1, it doesn't bother me. It's not like I'm going around looking, right, where can I spot the thing on the figure that looks really crap? I just appreciate it for what it is, and I think maybe they could have done something better with it, but considering everything they've done with the figure, it's like anything, you know, it's like the moaning about Cliff Jumper's parts forming. It's you've got a great figure that, you know, is probably the best version of that figure we've ever had. So
They're prioritising the robot modes more than the vehicle modes, but they're still making amazing vehicle modes. So.
Exactly. Yeah. And it's so G1-esque, again, for those of us who were big G1 fans and truck fans.
If you look back as well, though, they used to prioritise obviously, Diaclone originally used to prioritise the vehicle modes over the robot modes. Yeah. The cartoon, obviously, was the best of both. And now we're getting it's a lovely blend. Hoist specifically, I think his legs are very hard to actually get. And I don't think his legs actually in the cartoon actually were very good. So I think that figure, £16, Andy, you've just knocked me off my chair. That is phenomenal, really.
Only complaint I've ever seen about Hoist, for me personally, is his gun. You know, his hand thing, how it's the wrong colour. It's meant to be white and silver. I've painted mine because it's me. Nothing enters this room without being touched. But it didn't bother me. That's just my two cents.
No,
it's good. Who's next then?
Who would like to go next? Nathan, did you get any pickups this week?
Nope. I got a box of sweets and that's about it.
That is a pickup.
Fantastic.
That's a pickup of kings.
That's a he rogues.
do you want me to go then? Shall I go?
Okay, so you go.
Here we go. So I got this guy.
Big shout out to Dave Whitten's kids again.
Magic Square. Magic Square. Yeah.
Is that the same one you've got?
Magic Square Space Skimmer. It's the one I had actually. It's the one I almost.
Oh right, there you go.
He's really good. Let me just. I really appreciate it. So I've got like a window behind me, like behind the screen. So every day I see his eyes light up. So if you can see his. If it shows it at all on the screen, but his the light piping is really quite good in him. He's a really cool figure. I think it's quite for what he is. If I look him that way around, I can see his light piping straight away, like behind the scenes sort of thing. I think he's really quite cool. So I got him, which is really cool, for a really good price from a good buddy of TFUK. I got some other TFs. I got. This guy, Thundermass, I'm not going to show all of this. I've got Thundermass. So, Matt sent me this over. It's Mech Toys Thundermans, which is Legend Scale Power Master Prime. I used to have a Thunder Noir.
Erebus.
Thunder Erebus. Yeah, Thunder Erebus, which is the black version of him. And I loved him so much. I think he's actually better articulated than the Mech Toys version. Sorry, than the Fans Hobby version. So I got him. He came with the Divine Shooter armor, which is the break on it, which I've managed to actually sort out now. And his God Bomber as well. So what there was a break here, but luckily the Divine Armor comes with a spare armor. So I've got
wow.
So I've got two.
Did you buy him off of Matt?
Yeah, I got him off Matt.
So, you're the one I went to buy it and he said oh this sold.
And I've got this guy as well from Matt. So I got him as well. Which I haven't transformed yet, but he's got his big smiley face
what,
on.
What Mech is that?
And not that Double is Evil, is it? It's the other one.
MMC Carnifax.
So I've got how Double much did that cost?
So he's around the sort of 180-200 mark.
Wow.
I think. So I've got the Double Evil. If I just move my camera up a little bit, you'll see Double Evil is at the top of the camera there. He's right at the top. I've moved.
I'm more interested in the guy you just got.
Have you not seen Carnifax before, Jamie?
No,
he's one of RJ's favourites. He's often showed him off.
If you look, if you imagine the sort of size here of these two, right? And if you put his body armor on him, he stands about there. He's pretty good for Legends or Voyager. That sort of
yeah, he'd be chuggling actually, wouldn't he?
Yes.
Yeah.
I've never had him, so I wanted to get him just to play around with him. I might flog him on, or I might stick him into my Action Force collection for the moment. So which I'll reveal another day. And then
Ruby's armor would be quite good. I'm just thinking about that actually make working chug.
He's very cool. And then I got two figures. Now what I'd like to ask the podcast hosts is I've got two of the Stunticons this week. One of them is a Fans Toys, one of them is DX9. Okay, now I know you guys don't know as much about these MP fair parties, but Fans Toys is meant to be the renowned top bollocks one, right? And DX9 is meant to be like, it's good, but Fans Toys is meant to be up there, right? So which one of these figures, and I'm just going to bring the camera around here so you can see them, because I've posed them a little bit, so excuse the rest of the bullshit, but I'm just going to show you these now. So which one of these do you think is the Fans Toys, and which one do you think is the DX9?
The Fan Toys one looks as though it'd be the one on the my left.
Describe, but name them, please.
The red-faced one would be the Fan Toys one, but the DX9 one I think looks better, which is the gold-plated one.
I agree with Jamie.
You are correct, my friends. So Wild Rider came out, which was the Fans Toys, and I actually have my other Wild Rider up top there, which is the DX9 version. I transformed it and had a look at him, and if you look at Bobby Skullface or a number of other people which compared them, this blows it away. Yeah, this figure here actually is, and it's if you compare it to the size of an Autobot car, it's the same height as MP44. However, it will transform down into the same size alt mode as MP Prowl. So it's quite a phenomenal like feat, and he's just got ratchets everywhere, and he's such a good mold, and his gun does fall off a little bit. But even like the wheels are really good metallic gloss everywhere. It's so nice a figure. But then DX9 here, you can feel there's a massive weight difference. This DX9 figure is dead end is such a good figure. Their breakdown and their Wild Rider are pretty shocking, if I'm brutally honest. This guy is he's really good, and I'm actually very impressed. So you know, the price of him, he's actually only sort of like 70 quid. Oh shit!
No, you're saying that because it's got the.
You're acting.
Yeah, you're acting.
Yeah, I mean that's.
Yeah.
Oh, you jester!
He comes apart, so you can stick his.
Quit collecting.
He comes apart, so you can stick him onto on Menosaur's arm, so he splits apart. So quite a cool little alteration. So I can spend an hour transforming the bottom half.
The jazz effect.
Yeah. So as you can see, they've been posing sort of walking modes on my desk. Every time I touch them, they fall over. I'm really shocking at walking modes.
Damn walking modes.
They get me every time. So that, I'll probably end up selling my DX9 Menasor eventually, I think. So he's actually a really nice figure. He's up top here. You can see him holding his sword up here, up there, clenching his sword. And he's such a solid figure. But I just think I've got two others. I've got the X-Transbots up there as well. And I've also got the Fans toys now as well. So I'm just like, I don't need three versions of the same characters. So I will sell them. But I'm really happy about those. And I haven't transformed this guy yet, but I'm really looking forward to it. I saw some reviews, and apparently it's really intuitive and fun. And Fun and Fans toys hasn't been there for a while. So, and I felt that Iceman's transformation was actually okay. It wasn't too involved. I could see the bits of people complaining about, and there was even like a warning sticker on the box saying, don't bend this way because you'll break it. And I was like, oh, it's kind of common sense to put it in the right way before you do that anyway. I did that before because I didn't understand the instructions anyway. So being a man and all that. So that's me.
Brilliant. Thank you so much for that. That was actually really, really good. Right. And before I go on to my pickups, I just want to say well done to Samuel. Whilst we've been on the podcast, someone's texted in and said that his son has done really well. So he's bought him a six shot because he got a great school report. So well done, Samuel, on your school report. From your dad, well done, David Samuel. Widden. I wish I had a few good school reports. Right, so on to my pickups. Probably how much I got this week. I think it's all Iron Factory apart from one. So I will spotlight myself. There we go. So this is Cygnus, which is Iron Factory's version of Jetfire. As you can see, he's a pretty faithful. He's not too IDWized. I don't really like chest bit, the blue bits. I think I might paint over that bit, but other than that, he is an amazing figure. One of my favorite ones I've picked up recently. Two I was rather disappointed in was Runner Mark and Runner Mount. Runner Mock and Runner Bout. They're so generic. Like, there's no character to either of them. They don't even have room to put a big Decepticon sign on. And when Andy's pictures,
they're a retool of Sunstreaker. IDW did the original racing Rose, a Sunstreaker and Sideswipe.
I haven't got
because there isn't a magic square Sideswipe or anything else. The only Sunstreaker you can get is this version of him in yellow. So you're saying you wouldn't get the other ones in?
I would get them as a Sunstreaker and Sideswipe. I just think for these two, I was expecting really round and robust alt mode, which they don't have. It's really elongated. And I'd want room to smack that big Decepticon sign on. Neither of them have that.
They're very like generic. Almost like their version of Cliffjumper, aren't they? Like, it's just like, eh.
Yeah, just a bit meh. Just like, they didn't care that much. One guy who I wasn't, my expectations weren't that great for, but he does a standard good job as a Legends class, Shockwave, which is Iron Factory Shockwave, Bridge Watcher. Yeah, he's fine. He happily fill the spot of Mr. Shocks.
Tiny head.
Tiny head. Name of yours. And this is Sky Shadow, who I thought was really cool. I haven't checked his box, actually. I don't think it comes. A lot of Iron Factory come with different hands, don't they? I don't think this guy does.
They do, sometimes.
Yeah, I don't think this one does.
What's he transform into? Is he like the jet?
He's like Leo Kovy. He's another one which transforms into a goat. So cool. This one down.
Standard now for you, mate.
Back.
I can tell by the lack of horns, it was obviously a goat.
Yeah. He's got horns.
No, he turns into a plane.
Paul's got the horn, mate. Paul's got the horn. It looks a lot like the Generations Thunderwing that was then turned into Sky Shadow, or Black Shadow, or whatever you want to call it. It's got a lot of the same kind of design.
Yes, it has. It's got flappy wings as well. And
of course, a goat mode.
And a goat mode. So probably Cygnus was my favourite. But my second favourite was Optimus Prime himself, which is, it's one of their Commander series. I can't remember which one it is. Becomes with all the add-ons to make him into Godkin Rai.
Oh, wow.
But I just like him in this way.
Like, well, within Optimus Prime.
Yeah, it does. He's got the gun, and he's going to be my Prime for my Legend scale. And he came with this, which I've forgotten who it's meant to be. Is it the girl he falls in love with? Elita One.
Elita One. It looks a bit like RC, but...
Yeah.
It looks like RC who's been in a car crash and survived, but it's hideously deformed. Then I had another car crash and survived that. But yeah.
Garcy. Yeah,
it's such a picture with words, does that, Jamie?
And so the only thing I didn't realise this, which wasn't Iron Factory, was Mr. Moon Blaster. So he's probably Magic Square size. And yeah, he turned out as well. Oh, and Perceptor. Iron Factory Perceptor, I think, which I got for a fiver.
I'm sure it's Mr. Moon Perceptor, isn't it? I don't think there was other.
No, ones. I thought it was. I think it's Iron Factory's Perceptor.
Are you happy with the so you got, obviously you got the sort of almost like the what's it called, the IDW version of sort of like Power Master Prime or Godbomber sort of attachment? And the RC, do you like them? Are you happy with them?
I do, yeah, because I had what's his name, Lucifer, Steel Lucifer,
yeah,
which is basically the same mold, and he's okay. He came he's a bit broken.
Black version, isn't he?
White version. You can get the black version as well. He's the Nova Prime.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Version of him.
Nova Prime.
He's that version, and he's not as good by far. So I was a bit, I wasn't that up for getting this version of Prime. But
he's a lot of money because I've heard a lot of mixed.
He wasn't bang. Lisa. He was a packet of crisps.
Very cheap.
Some Watsits.
I felt for what he
Alexis,
was.
Alexis, what are you doing?
I felt
back away,
to...
Alexis. Back away.
I felt compared to, if you look at some of the Earthfry stuff, or like any, or even Racing Bros, or another one, I felt he was quite a lot of toy, and it was almost a gamble if you liked him or not. Personally, I read the review when he was online. I saw him online with the same person you bought it from, obviously, and I read the review and I was like, be interesting to find out what's going on. And obviously, by that time, before I even turned around, you've got him. So I was like, okay, we'll find out.
I was happy with him. I think he's better than Steel Lucifer. Good. I like that almost naval commander look in his prime mode. If he didn't have that, then maybe probably wouldn't like him as much. And he came with Elita One or RC as well. That's part of the pack he comes in. So it's cool to get two Iron Factory Transformers for £12.50. Right. Who's next?
Jamie, is it?
Yeah, it's me now.
Cool, brilliant. Right.
You didn't get anything this week, did you, Jay?
I got loads of stuff, but I'm only focusing on one thing this week. You know. So, basically, I got Scorponok, which I think most of the Transformer collectors of the Chug line have got this week. And it comes in a massive box.
The artwork on that is... pretty nice.
Oh, it's awesome, the artwork on it as well. It's just like, you know, it sets the scene, you know, it gives nice clear images.
On the side, one of the actual, the one of the doors, isn't there a picture of what looks like Megatron, the Megatron's fusion cannon shooting at Scorponok?
Well, it's someone's fusion cannon. I presume it's Megatron. It's hard to see
because
it's blacked out.
Yeah, but that's the thing. It's like a little bit of mystery. Why would it could be Braun?
Yeah, he's got Megatron's fusion cannon again, and he's decided to take a shot.
It's not on his shoulder. Wherever he had the damn thing.
Yeah,
punch. Punch. Poof.
You know, and obviously the box comes with a sort of like the typical map now, which you use to find Cybertron, and you've got your nice set of instructions. It also comes with there's also sort of like special effects which you can add on to the ports. And you've also got this sort of red little wee slide thing which you could use to sort of read the map.
That's a nice touch. That's a nice touch. They haven't. So I don't think we've actually discussed those explosions before. I think do all Earthrise figures come with those like little mini explosions, so you can actually have them.
No.
I see them quite a lot online.
You've got
just the Battle Masters, all the really big ones.
He's like a small child. He really is.
Good. He looks good, doesn't he?
He is your child now.
He's like, and he's quite damn heavy. See, when I transform this guy, I really need to use a table because, you know, he is freaking heavy.
You know, I think so we should make you keep holding it for a long time.
You know, and I've got him in an ankle tilt. I noticed some people complained in the forum picture.
Yeah, they did.
What the lack? You
know? At least you've got his toes folded out.
Jay, how's it? What's it look like from behind? Let's have a 360.
I know you always like to look at the backside. Now, I know
definitely.
I know a lot of people, when it comes to the back here, they like to have this bit closed.
Yeah. I
sometimes prefer to have it open because it just sort of hides that sort of gap in the leg.
You want to have a butt flap.
You know, like butt I just think it looks a bit sometimes slightly better like that, to be honest.
How wide, how far, you know, how far do his claws open?
And quite far, very far. You'll see him.
I haven't seen him.
Yeah, you'll see in the pictures.
I keep holding.
The thing I want to talk about.
Save your questions till the end, Alexis.
Yeah. Questions at the end.
The thing I want
we'll
to
take
talk
questions
about
at the end.
It's just the one niggly thing is it comes to his actual head. He's got a sort of socket here, and it's this thing here. It turns. Now, what you put in is you've got this plastic piece with you know, two little pegs, and they sort of fit in, and it sort of forms like the neck of the head, but also you use that to squeeze to turn it. To be quite honest, I think that's going to be a breaking point sometime in the future.
Oh, is this like when grapple exclusive? Because you pretty much busted the back out of grapple.
Because it takes quite a bit of force. And I don't know if it's a quality control issue, but I use an Allen key and it just turns really easy with an Allen key. Sorry. So I would rather take the head out and use an Allen key to turn it slightly.
Apologies, Jay. You're saying it's the stiffness of the actual ratchet to turn the head. You have to use the actual purple mechanism to actually turn it without that. If you use the head, it doesn't turn properly or you break it.
I think it's going to be a breaking point. You know, I think if you get lazy and you're trying to, and you're only holding one side of the neck, for example, you might only hold this side instead of the both, you could easily break it.
Yeah, it makes sense.
You know? So you want to use both, but a lot of people would have the head in there and use the head and turn it as well. And to be honest, a lot of people will talk about how they've lost parts of the headmaster because the headmaster comes out. And do you know how these things are designed to easily break and then fall apart? And I've actually already lost his arms, so his arms are already going to be here somewhere.
Oh, wow. So actually...
Is that you who posted about that earlier in the group?
No.
Because somebody posted saying that they'd lost the arm off it as well. They said they'd only had it out a day and they'd lost the arm.
So you actually have to use the headmaster, the actual Zarek headmaster, on top of the big headmaster to try and turn it. Because I think the original Fort Max, which I've got the Titans Return Fort Max, his head doesn't turn, I don't think.
Well, his arm comes out.
It does, but it's the same system. You put Cerebros on there, but you don't have to. I don't think you have to have Cerebros on there, but you can keep him on there and he slots in. I find mine's a bit stiff when I turn it.
You think you just have like four little pegs that come out of the top and they just plug in and that would just actually allow you to turn it at corners, right?
Possibly. But the arm actually isn't loose. It's just because of the mechanics being a headmaster and it's inside that big head, which people will tend to store it. So, you know, for example, it's because when you're probably turning it, it comes loose. But the actual figure itself, it's not loose.
Right.
You know, it's just the mechanics of, you know, taking it out and stuff. So you just have to be careful. But you don't need to actually store it in there. I mean, the head itself will go in quite fine. You could put this somewhere else.
Yeah,
you know,
that'd be good.
The only thing I do miss is I wish there was a nice, easy compartment to place them. I mean, what I do like about it is I think about the cartoon.
His chest
is when this opens up and you can have like Lord Zarek, well, he's Nebula in form anyway, he could be inside, and that was almost like the cartoon, you know. So that was quite cool. I like that, but I wish it was a simpler place to keep him because
hang on, can you not store him in that piece then?
No, not really. It's not many easy places, but Alexa, if you just let me.
Sorry, mate. I'm excited. I'm so excited.
Questions at the end.
Yeah. I mean, the thing is, the whole figure kind of plays homage to the Rebirth cartoon and the comics. So it's an amalgamation of the best bits of both. And, you know, it's almost like a dream come true. I mean, he is really solid and he's fantastic, but he seems to lack a lot of the little gimmicks, which make something even better. Which you think they could have maybe done. And he does need to come with more accessories. He's only got the two big shoulder guns. You know, he needs to at least that came with four. And the trouble is the guns get used in the base, but I'm going to show you some photos so I can discuss this when we're doing this. So advanced. That'll go there. Okay, so there we've got Lord Scorponok. Can you guys see it okay?
Yeah.
Ah, stunning. Cool. You know, so there he is in his robot form and his two big shoulder cannons. As I said before, it would have been really cool if he came with four. You can see his shield there on his arm, you know, which is a little bit better there. I mean, even then, half the shield comes from parts from his legs, so it almost feels like you're taking to make that shield, you're also missing something from the legs, which although it kind of paid homage to the original toy, I would have liked if they just had some more parts with it. I mean, I know someone third party are going to make accessories for this thing, and these accessories are going to be bought up because people will want it. So just going through Scorponok now. You know, I'm on his back again, pretty solid. I do wish that the tail could come up more like a stinger, like the original G1 toy, instead of being sort of packed back there. You know, I was trying to figure out how you could almost do it, but it wouldn't have the height. He has it in his Scorpion mode, which I think is probably the biggest beast transformer mode if you don't count Chipticon. You know, which basically is just a massive dinosaur. Again, I would have liked the two cannons on his, you know, on the top there, on the back, you know, just behind his stinger, in front of his stinger even. But you're kind of stuck, you've only got two cannons, you know, so I guess you're putting them on the arms. I do like how the head, you know, just for the, you know, artwork themselves, you know, turns into a sort of makeshift eye. I do wish, in some cases, they had kind of made it like the G1 Scorponok, where you had a crash helmet, which you would sort of fit into. You know, because I do miss the fact it would have been cool to have a sort of like a compartment he could easily fit into and Lord Zayak can come out. I do know the chest can open up and he can fit in there, but to be honest, it's a bit pish. You know, there's nothing like imaginative about it. It's just like something just to store some, you know, Michael Masters or something like that. He is from the side. The one thing I didn't do was actually, he didn't seem to wheel across like the old one, so I don't know if his legs would move, so I don't think that would at all. His legs are quite poseable. You know, they've all got, you know, numerous different joints like a finger, you know, which is quite cool, because you need to do that to sort of fit it into the chest piece when he's in robot mode. But it does look awesome. The Scorpion is spot on, fantastic. You know, I can't complain, apart from complaining, which I just did about the Lord Zarek head. But the base mode sucks. It looks cool, but, you know, again, because they lack things like guns, I mean, I know they've got lots of ports. So the idea is you're meant to be putting in special effects from other Transformers. You're meant to be using the Weapon Masters to make those guns, the Micro Masters that combine to form a ridiculous gun, which you would never do.
Can you, Jay, to interrupt one question? Sorry, his rams that come off the side there, can you attach those to MicroMaster bases at all?
I think you can. I didn't even try. But even so, Skylynx had something like six rams, and this guy only has, you know, three rams.
Hmm.
You know, Skylynx had like six. He had rams coming out everywhere. And Skylynx obviously had the towers, which you could mount the guns on top. We're here to make the towers, you have to use the guns. So you're taking away these two big cannons to make the towers.
The guns don't detach then?
Make the tower so you don't see the claws, because the claws are right behind it, which you'll see in the next photo, Alexis. Do you see? So the guns and the tower, the part of the sort of scrapping up
the claws.
And there's leg bits, aren't they, which go onto his legs?
Although it looks good, it just doesn't seem to do much. You know, it doesn't have all these wee gimmicks, you know, like the Michael Master bases would have lots of gimmicks coming out of everywhere, you know. And maybe it's something I haven't discovered, you know, yet. But it doesn't seem that way. When we came to Skylynx, there seemed to be so many cool little stuff which was happening. I mean, I do like the orange ramp there. That sort of folds into the legs, so there's some nice folding, and it sort of like slides out, and that's cool.
But I think it looks really cool, mate. I think it does look really cool still.
It does look cool, but do you see what I mean? Like, play-wise, you know, there's just not much to do. I mean, that's my only thing. You know, there's Lord Zarek. That's such a figure, which pays, again, homage to the Rebirth cartoon. You know, he's quite a big guy. Remember when he was basically having a conversation with Galvatron as he's flying away from Cybertron? They were basically almost as if they were like equal height, nearly, or He was definitely like half the height of Galvatron. He certainly didn't seem like a little human.
Hmm.
You know, and there's his little headmaster, the Nebulon, which I don't think actually has a name, but I just call him Lord Starek anyhow. There's a close-up picture there. And for scale, I've taken some images there. So there I'm with Commander class, Jetfire. And then I've got Leader class, Shockwave there. And then I've got Soundwave or Soundblast as he's called, Voyager class. And then I've got Deluxe class, Scrapface.
Jetfire only comes up to his waist.
Yeah, he's a big lad. You know, he's a big solid lad. I do love the figure. If you know, if all the negativity there, you know, I'm thinking about negatives there, but the positives are he's so solid and he just looks awesome. You know, there's some of the Autobots equivalent. There he is, you know, next to Skylynx, Optimus Prime, Ultra Magnus, just to give you an idea of the scale he is towards these guys.
I get what you're saying about the gimmicks. Sorry, no, go on.
Oh, no, no. Please.
No, it was just like when you looked at Metroplex, the original G1 Metroplex, and you had like little panels which undone and there was like bullets in there and then little things which came out and there was ramps for your little minicons.
Mm. Yeah.
Have you got the Siege Omega Supreme as well?
Yeah, I'm going to be coming to that. I mean, there he is next to Metroplex, and is again, even Metroplex has more gimmicks than Scorponok.
Really?
Know? Yeah, and that's gimmicks you could even touch on the actual robot himself. You know,
he's well sought after toy Metroplex, generation Metroplex.
But the thing is, height wise, you know, there's like, you know, there's Scorponok in more of a sort of power stance, and I'd make sure his ankles would tilt just to give him that bit more height. And it's like same height really as Metroplex. There's not any much in it at all.
Mm.
There it is next to Fortress Maximus. Fortress Maximus is a little bit taller, much bigger, a bit bigger, but you know, again, not much in it at all. You know, Scorponok definitely feels more weighted than Fortress Maximus, especially with those claws.
It's leg day versus arm day, isn't it?
Yeah. There you've got Chipticon.
That's no arm day there.
Chipticon can't do anything with those arms. How does he get to the toilet? How does he use the toilet? I don't know. There he is with Omega Supreme.
Bigger, isn't he?
Well, it's his head is much bigger than Omega Supreme, isn't it?
Shoulders as well, the shoulders.
Yeah, because the way the shoulders are positioned, they're quite fixed. Everything else has got joints and it can move. The shoulders are quite stuck where they are.
I was going to ask you the question. What the question I wanted to ask you, I said, have you got Omega Supreme? I was going to say, did you notice enough differentiations with the transformation to make him unique? Or did you think it was just, you know, just a repaint almost?
To be honest, when I was transforming Scorponok, I didn't actually need the instructions because he was so much like the G1.
Mm.
You know, so I don't know about Omega Supreme because Omega Supreme was a nightmare to transform. I used the instructions and stuff like that. And
every version is. I've had two third-party versions and they're exactly the same. Ball-like.
Yeah. Scorponok, I mean, definitely going from base mode back to robot mode was just so easy. You know,
I was going to ask, if in his base mode, if you took off his cannons from his from the tower, I know it reveals the claws, but are they able to actually attach anywhere else to your knowledge? Oh,
well, yeah, you could attach it into any peg.
Okay,
that's the thing. Nearly is next to Power of the Primes. Well, that's a KO version, which is the same size as Predaking. There he is next to Devastator, just giving you a height of some more of the Titan-class figures. And there he is to a typical Combiner Wars figure, Victorion. Cool. You know, so he's like massive there. There he is compared to the original G1 Scorponok. You know, you can see the colour is just like spot on. You know, there's so much of the shape. Everything is virtually the same.
Yeah, that's good.
Take us on to work day.
Yeah.
Not looking at, I mean, at G1 without one to go, it's precious.
No, see, that the thing was, I was saying to Mila, and I was going, I'm going to buy two Scorponoks. I'm going to have one displayed in the Scorpion mode. But the Scorpion mode is so ridiculously big. I just decided I'm not doing that because, do you know how when you transform something, it sometimes gets smaller and more compact? the Scorpion mode does not feel like it got anything in small. It feels like it just stayed the same size, if not got somehow bigger. You know, and I don't know how that worked out, because it was just like this huge monstrosity. A wonderful monstrosity. But I could imagine a kid playing something like that now, it'd be like the size of the child pushing. The child would probably have to use both hands to push the thing along the carpet.
If it had batteries, he could ride it.
Yes, you know. There he is with his original team from the Rebirth. You know, Weird Wolf, you know, Skull Cruncher, Mindwipe, you know, Cyclonus, Bullpipe, Misfire, Eight Face. Can't wait to get Snapdragon to complete the family shot. But I mean, it's the Rebirth. It's a Rebirth cartoon, which if no one's seen that, you have to watch, because, you know, I still think it's one of the best of the Transformer cartoons. And it's definitely pays homage to those characters.
Great.
And there he is with the sort of comic edition, so any excuse to get my classic Pretenders in there. But because Scorponok was basically behind the Pretender technology.
And in the comic books he was, yeah, wasn't he?
Yeah, and so the Pretenders were part of his Decepticon army.
He created them.
In IDW, you mean? I thought it was...
No, in the original Marvel comics.
Oh, yes, okay. Sorry, apologies, yes.
The 80s.
Yeah, so I was sort of putting some of the team together. There was just some artistic shots. I was trying to replicate what you saw in the box.
You know, looks really good, mate.
It's good.
Is that a green screen you've got there, or is that something else? Or
no, that's just a monitor. That's a screen. So that's, I have the monitor way back in the background, and then I'm standing way, way back with my camera to take that shot.
I love what you've done with his visor. I don't know if that's a light on his on the actual bottle, or if that's
No, that's thanks to Paul's help, which I'll say no more.
yeah. What I love about that shot, just to add to that shot, really, is it's so hard to actually get a Transformer in proportions, the correct proportions, to kneel down like that. Every Transformer I've ever got, maybe 2 out of 400 can do that. Most of them have a longer thigh or a longer bottom leg, and it's just like they can punch the ground, but they can't do that. That's quite impressive to be able to do that as well. So
the one complaint I have about this ankle tilt thing, it seems to be ankle tilts all the time, and I don't like it so much, because I think it's the Conservative Party that spoiled it for me, because every time I see a Conservative MP, they're doing this sort of power pose with their legs spreading apart. And I'm just thinking, I don't want my freaking Transformer looking like an MP, a Conservative MP, you know. And I just wish the ankles would go another way, so that they would go up like the heel. And I think that would be cool. And they keep doing it as if you've got rickets and your ankles are going to break. But yeah,
it'd be the evolution. That'll be the next. Because I remember
Legends do it externally.
I got to use my other Transformer I got this week, but I'll talk about him better next week. Zombie Prime, dead Prime. he's asleep Prime. You know, alternate universe
Prime. Just sleeping.
Yeah, you know. And so I sort of moved him in with my artistic flair to show that Optimus is sleeping now, children. He's not dead.
But you know what I'm most shocked about, Jay, is the fact that you didn't just use Paul's Photoshop to do that, and you spent a sum of money, I will not say how much, it's really cheap, if anyone's watching, on that bot. You bought that bot. But I'm very glad that you've got use out of him, because so far no one else has. You're the first person.
To be honest, the alternate Prime was a steal at £14.99, and it was the best £14.99
I've ever seen. Yes, of course it was.
Yeah. Buy one, get one free.
Fantastic. They were almost giving it away, Mayland. Giving it away, they were. You know, I couldn't say that. But anyway,
nothing to see here.
Can I ask as well, what are the explosions on top? Sorry, you've got your MicroMaster up there, your wonderful MicroMaster. What are the explosions doing?
That was just basically the plastic pieces. I decided just to use them in the photos.
Okay.
You know, to be honest, I would prefer to get much better at Photoshop and put in really cool explosions, but I don't have the skill to do that. It's just taking me this long to figure out how to, you know, to rename a file. Never mind, you know, put special effects in.
The photos are wonderful, Jay. I really do think they are proper, like, 10 out of 10. You've done it. You know, when I saw them online, I was like, whoa, these things, I was like, jaw-dropping, these things blew me away. You spent a lot of time and effort on it, and it shows, and they do come across really well, mate. You
applaud yourself. To be honest, I think the thing is like, I think we know the true artistic talent is Paul when it comes to photos. Because we both thought one of his planes, his photograph of a plane was an actual plane at an airport. And we were thinking, why the fuck is he sharing pictures of planes at airports? We're not interested. Yeah,
Why is he going on holiday, the wanker? How's he got out of the country?
Yeah, he's taking a photo on his airport, going away. And then I've seen the displays that you set up, Alexis, you know, in your displays, the sort of scenes that you do. So that's quite cool. Andy's like me, I think we're so restricted for space, we've just got characters like...
Yeah, they're all rigid. Just standing. They just stand there like they're not moving.
Yeah, static.
But you know what I mean, just static.
Yeah.
With the ankle tilt thing, I've slightly got them now into slight poses, but not too much.
Stoic.
Right, have we got any more pickups?
No.
Well, I do, but I'll save them for next week.
All right,
I've got one more, but I want to do a whole thing next week on it. So, spoilers.
Nice.
You weren't plugged in. Yeah, you can. You weren't plugged in when we were talking about.
Before you get to see anything,
I got really excited. I'm going to show you
everything the questions are about. No, cool.
I'm so sorry.
You had a little sleep, it's good.
I'm not joking, I actually did fall asleep. I just heard Alexis moaning about someone and I'm awake again. I will say one thing about
Alexis waking you.
The fact with Scorponok. I'll be interested when the Japanese get his hand on him because it means you'll get Black Zarek.
Yeah.
Well, we've already seen that his little wannabe character. Fast Track can turn into a sphere, so
I'd be quite interested to see how that's going to play out when the Japanese, if it will become a box set for them.
Yeah, it could well be.
Maybe it'll be some chopsticks.
I have to ask Mark on that one, won't we, guys?
Because Takara have not done a lot, have they? Like,
they haven't touched any Earthrise. I haven't seen any Earthrise Japanese ones yet. I haven't seen a single thing. I wouldn't be surprised if they take when Inferno comes out, if they do Art Fire, you know, the Japanese exclusive Target Master.
I'm making one. Well, when seeming Japanese get some figures have a Japanese homage, they always look quite cool, don't they? It's like samurais and stuff like that. And I just wonder when it comes to other nationalities, other nations, would they ever do a sort of homage figure? I mean, would you have a Transformer that looks like a Morris dancer? Would you come with accessory pole? Because we saw Bumblebee in one episode pole dancing, didn't
we? Mr. J. You
have to be leader. Cognitron.
Cool, like beauty and scale. Is in the eye of the beholder.
True.
Well, say it, Jamie.
No, it's not.
I am dead inside.
Before we enter that debate,
no doubt
our
there.
Discussion
Sorry, Nathan.
And our customs area is going to be all about Nathan this week. So Nathan, someone we met on Transformers UK, he started posting stuff. I saw about three things you posted, Nathan, and I didn't put them together at first. I thought, fuck, that's amazing what he's posted there. And then like a month later, I think you posted something else. It's like, wow, what a great transformation, what a great custom. And then a month later, something else came out. I thought, this is all the same guy who's posting this. Yeah. So we've been fans from the start. But do you just want to take us through some of your favorite customs, your
feelings?
You can
ask away, it'll be easy if you ask, because we try to do our ramble for ages with a stutter.
So I guess a good question would be, what was the first custom? What got you started? What made you wake up one day and you went, you know what I'm not going to do today? I'm going to make a Transformer.
Was when Titans Return was basically ending and there wasn't a Cliff Jumper, so I made a custom Cliff Jumper who I think is dead on my desk.
Dead jumper.
Just ignore the wheels are gone. I took him off for a project and then I lost him. But he is now no longer in use because of Earthrise. So that's what started off my customs mainly.
It started off with Cliff Jumper. And then what was next?
Yes. I don't know. I can't remember. I really can't remember what I did next.
So what would you say is what's your most recent favourite? My most recent favourite would be definitely Sound Blaster.
I mean, Oh, Blaster, you mean, not Sam Blaster.
Oh, yeah, sorry, Blaster.
I was thinking, I haven't made that one.
it's not mine.
I don't know, I'm torn between, like, Point Blank and Fizzle.
Oh, yeah.
Is it Fizzle? Fizzle. Was it Sizzle? I don't remember the name of those two bots.
So talk us through Point Blank there.
That one.
Point Blank was really, really impressive. We showed that one. I think Alexis showed that one on the podcast a few episodes ago.
I think it was the last episode.
Amazing.
Just ask me. I don't know where to start.
So just take a step back then. Do you make customs for yourself mainly, or for other people, or is it a combination of both?
Mainly for myself, but I've only started doing commissions in the last couple of months. With customs for me, I'll only make a custom of a bot who doesn't have a current figure.
Mm-hmm.
I do, every now and then I will do an occasional original character, like I've got, I don't know if it's easy to see or not, probably not, I'll pitch the camera up. This one,
this is impressive, this one, I like this one.
This is the very well-famous knockoff Thompson Tank Engine Combiner, what is completely modified with custom joints and everything, and then a Tie Master with a custom face.
Look at that. So this is like raiding, eat your heart out, mate.
He's called Steamworks, because I got the name because it was the same week they announced Ironworks, and I thought it was a funny name.
Oh, cool.
And then the headmaster I called Conductor, because it's a pun on words, because it's the guy who controls the train.
Mm.
Well, he's the guy who controls the robot, so Conductor worked.
So don't sell it short, Nathan. If anyone Googles Thomas the Tank Engine Combiner,
mine does actually come up.
I believe
it does.
And you look at the comparison between how this originally looked. It was literally, I think it was like Thomas, James, and Henry.
It was like it was meant to be Percy, but it was like a big green thing.
It was a shocking version.
Oh, honestly, it's a figure you wouldn't give to a kid, because it had so much sharp plastic. I've had to go in with all custom parts and fill it all gaps and everything else. Again, I've used different model kit parts. I've used magnets, complete repaints, custom badges, everything.
So if you haven't got a part, then obviously, you know, we talk about, obviously, you know, you would do a custom if there wasn't original one already.
Technically,
you wouldn't do, you know, repaints almost, but...
I will do repaints if it's a character, it is just a repaint. I will maybe do
it. I know. I understand what you're saying, but so where would you go to get those parts? And if you couldn't find a part, obviously a transformer is a transformer. Where do you go to get these additional parts? Do you go to a parts store? Do you go to Junkers? What do you do?
Yeah, mine's.
depending what part it is. If it's a head, half the time I'll either go on Shitways and buy the part. Like with Blaster here, that's a 3D printed Shapeways head in very high quality.
So Shapeways is a 3D printing company.
Yeah, people upload their custom designs on there. When it gets bought, Shapeways gets a cut, and the person who makes it gets a cut. Not a big cut, but they get a cut anyway. It's not the cheapest thing in the world, and I always say that, but it's the best place to get half the stuff. Like, every one of these, I believe, has a 3D printed head. Dogfight, Slapdash, Blaster, and Sizzle. And Sizzle has a 3D printed chest, all are custom from Shapeways.
So you can go on Shapeways and you can type
you can,
in...
There's a good chance you'll find what you're looking for, or you'll find something you can work into. Like with Slapdash, this head's actually for Combiner Wars Mirage. Mm. And the ball joint's different, so I had to make a new custom ball joint just to get the head on.
Wow.
And that gun's Shapeways as well.
If somebody comes to you with an idea, then let's say, for example, we were talking about figures we'd love to see made, and like for me... I love the trigger cons like Crankcase and Ruckus, for example. Would you automatically be able to think straight away, right, I could use this figure for the base, or do you need to go away and take some time? And
I tend to talk it out with someone, see what they want. I don't go off going, oh, this is how I'm going to do it. I like to have the person's point of view. And anything I do, let's say I have an idea, I will not go do the idea first. I'll pass it through someone, the person I'm working with, and see if they like the idea.
Yeah.
Like, the one I'm working on currently is... I've dropped a piece. Is this evil Siege Mirage. what has a 3D printed head. This isn't the thingy one, the one that comes in the box set of Impactor.
Yeah.
It's a 3D printed head, but he wanted these to be white originally. Well, I said it's a Decepticon. It makes no sense to really have white on it, so I decided to go with a grey primer, so it's darker. So I always pass it through. I don't ever just go, we're doing this, and that's it. But
what paints do you use? Have we discussed this?
I use airbrush paints. They're quite cool. You can see there's a bunch of stickers on the table.
Yeah.
This is actually the place I get my... I'm not sponsored. I just have these decals because the desk is knackered, so I just had decals on it. But the paints I get are known as Zero Paints. The company's called Zero Paints. They're all color matched to actual cars. Like the yellow I'm using on a customer at the moment is a Honda Civic yellow. I've got purples from Porsches. Like the shattered glass prime is a purple from a Porsche. I've got colors glow. I've got a Tic Tac green, the color of actual Tic Tacs. And that's the one who I painted. I think you talked about before my two original character twins. What that guy in the group had a right go at me for. When the group came together and told him to sod off, and I loved it.
Yeah.
I mean, I wanted to ask you, when you talk about the paints, are you spray painting or do you use the paint and brush them on?
I've got it wrapped around the wrong thing. I use that. It's an airbrush. Right. So the paints are actually a liquid. Then you just turn on, if I can get it. Just an airbrush, it feeds through there, comes through, and it just paints on it. We have to use an air compressor. I'm hitting everything.
So going right back to layman's end, so you prime it and then paint it.
Yes, you don't ever want to just put paint on because it's not going to stick. You need a primer is used to make the paint grab. If you point paint straight on top, it will come off. I've had failures where, what's his name? It's the head for. This is a commission I'm working on. I actually failed on this paint like twice, and the headmaster is now stuck. Oh, come on, bugger! There we go. You see the head? How it's like somewhat charred.
Mm-hmm.
I put the primer on, but the primer didn't take because I didn't realise because the face is actually initially yellow. It's painted yellow. Well, I should have took the paint off first and then primed it, but because it was on a glossy material, the primer didn't stick and it ruined the face.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's always best to prime something. Off?
Would you use sand?
I either use paint stripper or I use 70% alcohol or 100% alcohol just to knock it back. It does wonders. Like the best way to say, alcohol, if you ever have a figure that has like, let's say a G1 when you take the decals off, you want to replace them. You know how it has like sticky residue on the back of it?
Yeah.
Put that stuff on it and it will knock that residue off completely. That's literally what that stuff is good for.
If you look at the figures you've got there in front of us, if you say like Dogfight, for example, what was the process behind him? Where did you know from start to finish? What did you do?
Originally I said I started with Backstreet. I saw a custom online of basically the same thing, but I thought in my usual mind is I can do it better. And then Backstreet came out, and I wanted to do Dogfight because I said it's these guys haven't got modern figures and I wanted to make modern. To start with him, I must have spent about 2 weeks trying to find a figure what worked, trying to get the same Dogfight style of figure with the, you know, the swept backed upwards wings, what I should come off the arms is not easy. So I asked around everyone in the group figures, and I think one of the guys said to use, I forgot the name,
Darkwing.
Darkwing.
And then
Generations.
From there, I was just content to do the new redesigned wings because I've actually added a piece here, if I can get the nose cone up, where it actually turns up, where these usually just go straight back.
Wow, that's just amazing.
Started doing that, and then I thought I'd go... I always think, I'll start doing little things, and then I'll go a bit more, and a bit more, and then I don't stop.
It's almost like you've got so much mechanical engineering changes you do. It's not just like repainting something and a little bit of shaping. You bring in mechanical changes as well.
With my customs, for myself, I always aim for has to have the G1 look in the auto in the robot mode, but it can have a modern twist. AKA, I'm making doing chug myself, basically. It has to work within the context. It can't be one or the other. It can't be wildly, it can't be just the character in the same colours, and it can't just be a straight version of the G1, because I might as well just buy the G1 figure at that point.
Do you ever sketch out your ideas or sort
no, because
like
I can't draw.
Do you ever mock anything up beforehand?
Nope.
Or it's a case of you,
it's
you
just case
crack,
if
you,
it,
you crack on and see if it works.
Yeah, you crack on and see if it works, and if it doesn't work, it gets ripped off with some pair of pliers.
Yeah, fail fast and all that, so yeah.
It's like this Mirage, it's the one no one liked, but then I modified it and people seem to love the figure now. Yeah. Well, I take it, it's the Combiner Wars.
I just realised which one figure that is as well. And yeah,
it's a very highly modified Combiner Wars one.
What did you change about him? I don't know the original. What did you change?
I hated that Combiner Wars figure.
Oh,
these are the... awful. I take it you know what these are.
They look like the weapons from the current Mirage.
They are. They're his weapons Siege. With a modified missile. I took off the peg and added an extra fin.
And then
I also used his head. That's the Siege head, not the Combiner Wars.
Mm-hmm.
But then it's just 3D printed parts. I'll transform it, it's just easier to show, because it shows you the car mode. This one was the one done out of a passion. Because Mirage is one of those characters I love, but this figure never worked because Mirage is an old F1 car, where this is meant to be dragship first, is meant to be an Indy car.
You mentioned that you're a
car fanatic, and you like your racing as well, and obviously you're an Autobot fan as well. Is Mirage your favourite?
No, because I don't like F1.
You said he's Indy car though.
Yeah.
That version was.
Ah, so who's your favourite Autobot character then?
Wow, that's awesome.
Looks so G1, that's fantastic.
So again, the arms have been chopped off and then sanded down, so they don't have those lips over here anymore. The wing's been chopped down. It's a custom 3D printed end, what just attaches to the original ball joint. Then the back of it's been taken off, so it doesn't have the back parts, so that it just looks like Mirage. And then that's been sanded down to have it more of the airbox.
It looks better than my bloody third-party £100 one.
Yeah, and then these decals are actually the Toy Hacks decals, what I just put on and then cut with an exact knife around the edges to make it fit perfectly.
Wow.
And there's also a Liger. What is the racing team?
What do you use to cut into the plastic?
Just an X-Acto knife.
So if somebody wanted a custom and came to you, how much does it cost, depending on like the size of the figure?
Depends on class.
Right.
Well,
Base price
punching.
Let's see, if you start with a Legends, it's gonna be 20 just for a straight repaint. Any custom parts you have to order on top, but how my prices work, every classic goes up, it gets an extra £10. So Legends is 20, Deluxe is 30, Voyager is 40, and then Leader is 50, and so on. If you want to do like a Leader Prime, it's 55 because I've got to do this sodding trailer.
How long does it take to actually? If you looked at your Leader Prime there, or your Dogfight as two examples, how long would they take? About the same sort of time, or?
I'm just going to turn that screen off so you can see. Prime actually took about, wait a minute, I don't know, like 2 days of work.
Wow.
And that's, when I say that, I don't mean 2 days in total. That's 2 days time all the way through, not 2 days separately.
Oh, right. So, okay.
I do it over how much time I would have spent on a figure. So it must be about maybe 15 hours of work. Mm-hmm. I don't glorify things. It's a hobby, not a job.
I would go further. I think it's a passion. You enjoy it.
It's really fun.
Every time we chat, you want to get back into doing this. You love doing this thing. So it's if you didn't enjoy it as much, you probably would charge more, I think. So I think
I come from a background of making model cars and model kits from Japan, so I have that knowledge of building stuff. Like, if I can just grab it.
What about
your lightsaber? I do stuff like this.
Wow.
I used to do stuff like that. But then I didn't like the hobby anymore because it got very, very stale. Because with model cars, you can't do anything besides really build them. Then I switched to a different hobby, and that's where I picked up all my skills for scratch building and stuff. And then I came into Transformers.
How are you getting with your lightsaber?
I bought that.
but you enjoy that as well, don't you?
I'm a Star Wars fan, yeah. But yeah. I bought making custom Transformers and buying over a £200 17-inch lightsaber was a bit of a different thing.
I thought you were still building.
This is Alexis is going to start asking about your
I'm still buying the rest of my lightsaber.
Do you want to know what I'm having for dinner tomorrow, Alexis?
I think you're...
I thought you had to put it together still. I thought it was like a...
Oh, no, it comes in parts, yes, but you just have to screw it together, but still 200 something quid.
Oh, okay.
You might be thinking of that.
Okay, would you do me a favour, Nathan? Would you just show me your backstreet, which sounds awful? But would you? So, I had this guy as a kid, and I was absolutely blown away. And it's the blur mold from RID 2015, isn't it? You've used.
Look at this.
What? How the hell did you decide to use that mold? Because
I will be honest with this one. It isn't originally my idea. Someone else has done this before, but it was just a straight repaint.
Mm.
In my mind with most customers is, oh, that's a cool custom. I could probably do it better. And then I go the extra mile.
You've actually customed it. You haven't repainted it. And what I see is there's a lot of people, they call themselves customizers, don't they? And they just
paint it. They are repainters. It's the same thing, because I come from a people who do Warhammer, so kit bashing. Mm. There's a thing people who do kit bashing who go, oh, I've done a kit bash, when they've just used one kit. Well, it's like, no, you haven't kit bashed it. You just built it wrong.
Kit bashing is when you use multiple kits to make it.
Yes, it's like
anything. It doesn't just have to be kits. You can use
best
your
way to the best excuse for kit bashing bobs on here is dogfights a kit bash, because that's that is the
multiple things together. Like,
oh, what the bloody hell's the name?
It's sound wave.
It's sound waves missile thing. I've just cut down and shrunk and put it on his arm, because they just tab in.
My little brother always used to criticize me because I always just like. Because obviously the ports used to fit on Warhammer, like different products, the different and then like my brother, oh no, it doesn't go there, it's go here. I'll go, but it looks really cool. No, it goes here, it goes here, it goes here. I'm like, okay, fine.
Okay.
Wow.
That's
super fast.
That looks fantastic.
Yeah, well, super fast for you. And being,
yeah.
The nose has been...
I've been able to transform it. I would have to get Paul to show me what to do.
Yeah, the nose has been cut down because the nose used to come out to about here. Yeah. Shrunk it down. So the wrist ball has been removed. The these are custom built Gundam parts. It's a Gundam lightsaber. It's a axe handle with a bit of pipe from the Magnus hammer from Transformers Prime, the one Magnus comes with, and then the end is a Titan Master gun from the Power Master Prime, the black guns he had.
How did you come up with that? How did you see that? That's just phenomenal.
Around looking for gun parts. I've got drawers behind me. I've got three sets just full of parts. And if I don't have the part, it gets made out of this stuff. What is just styrene card. It's plastic card.
Mm. Do you ever use green stuff from Warhammer?
But I didn't like it. I prefer putty and stuff. When it comes to Warhammer, though, I'm better with stuff like that. That's what I mean. That's where my skill has come from, stuff like this.
That's an orc. Orc, is it? Or goblin?
Yeah, but this is completely custom built. This isn't a kit.
Nice.
But that's where the hobby... That's why I can do somewhat this. I'm not the best at it. There's like... With Blaster, there is a problem where you can still... Well, you probably can't, but I can still see the design from Soundwave's chest. I can still see it.
Have you ever thought of... getting old vintage Transformers and restoring them somewhat using your skills?
Talking of that, let me grab him. Drop the controller, it's dragging my head to the floor, you prick. Come here, you nutter.
What's the red Transformer? Not Prime.
This is a fully restored G1 Prime.
Wow.
Cool. And the arm was broken, so I fixed it with some Lego. There's a Lego stud in there, Lego pin.
Oh my god, it is, yeah.
Lego Prime, love it.
These are reproduction hands, and then the chrome's been redone with a chrome pen, and then it's just retro labels on top.
Because that's what I've done with some of the Mako Masters I've bought. You know,
there's also a mod I've done. I have made it so his head turns.
Oh, look at that!
When you take his head off, there's actually a peg underneath his neck. If you just chop that off, you can make the head turn.
Oh.
Wow!
So you've improved on it as well.
If you could do this full time, Nathan, would you do it? If there was enough people that are saying, I want this, I want this, I want this, I want this, would you do it full time?
No.
No?
It will take the enjoyment out of it.
Ah.
Yeah.
You do a hobby.
You're doing it for fun.
You do a hobby because it's a hobby, not because it's a job.
Yeah.
I used to be a photographer and became a studio and wedding photographer, and it killed my passion for photography. Yeah,
if you do a hobby as a job, it can sometimes work, but it will kill it for you, I think.
Mm. So who do you like? What customizers do you like?
Who do you aspire to?
I don't really. Honestly, before I started doing all this, I didn't look at any.
That's probably a good thing, because you get ideas set in your head.
How I tend to do customs, say, I will go, oh, I want to do this. Let's see if someone else has done it. If someone has, I would tend to either avoid what they've done or not do it.
So on that sort of segue, could I show you a couple of customs that have come out this week and get your opinion on it and like see, you know, would you and again you can say whatever you like about them, obviously. But it's
not racist.
I will be admit I'm very, very, very opinionated.
We think they're very cool.
That doesn't come across at all.
If someone asks me opinion, and someone's like, "What do you think?" and if I honestly think it's crap, I will tell it to their face. I'm not.
These are all off my Facebook. I subscribe to different groups and they're awesome. So this is Combiner Wars esque, and I believe it is. It's Onslaught. Combiner Wars Onslaught. If I go back to the original picture, probably easiest.
Yeah, it's Combiner Onslaught,
and then you've got a couple of I think they're grooves.
They're Retgars. Weird Wolf down the front. That's what's it called from the Terracons?
No, that's Swoop.
Yeah, I think it works.
I think it's the same.
I think it's.
No, it's definitely. But
I know what you mean. But it's not Swoop. It looks like Swoop in robot mode.
Ripclaw, is that what he's called? No, Cutthroat.
I think it looks pretty good, actually.
It is amazing, because I talk to Stephen a lot. We bounce off ideas off each other a lot.
It's clever. It's about seeing it. You see so behind it.
Because see how he has, if you go back to the Combiner Wars one, the combined mode, sorry. Those feet are one of the best feats you can have for a combiner. I gave him the idea for that.
Where are they from?
They are... Perfect Effect feet, Combiner Wars. They are actually the Starscream feet. I have the exact same one on my own custom combiner, Hyperdrive, the Turbomaster combiner.
Oh? I think that's really cool.
Why is there a beat of silence when I said Turbomaster combiner?
I was just having a sip of my wine, that's all.
I want to get
the TFC version of Road Caesar. This is another one I saw today, which is his Erector. So... For those looking at the screen right now, it's a beautiful version. It's actually Toy World's Hook, which has been customized, and they've taken the back off of him and then used that with Power Master Prime's trailer. As you can see, it comes out on both sides.
The
original hook, and there's your bit in the middle, so it comes out as an extension to hook, so that the crane would look here. And that's actually a very good MP version of
a Maker Master.
Yeah, I think it works pretty well, actually. I was like, wow, that's pretty creative. So,
saw that and I thought that was an official product. So I just.
Yeah, it looks very esque of the actual original toy. What do you think, Nathan?
I don't know the character. It's an amazing looking custom, but I don't know the character. That's the thing.
I will get.
I know, I've seen the images of Rector. Because you type his name in, you get a very nice GIF.
Let's
work it out. Let's get it right.
Even if you put his name in, you'll still get that GIF. You can see it there. I can see it.
Yeah, that
Mr.
one.
Happy Hook.
But
I know who Erector is. Yeah, see, I was when I saw that, I was tempted to make my own version of Erector.
Yeah. So if you go back to that, it does look very.
Yeah.
Apart from that particular...
Yeah, but the gun's been replaced with the crane, so...
Exactly. No, because there always was the crane there.
No, I mean with how they've done with that one. They've just used the crane instead.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, exactly. So, I think it's... Yeah.
It's amazing work.
Oh, no, they have got the gun. Look at that.
Yeah. And it's incorporated the drone as well, the repair droid.
Yeah, I think it's very good. Yeah. And the last one, which is a small video, so I've got it halfway through, which I will show.
Yeah, with sound, I've learned that.
I'm going to do it without sound, so we can chat over it. It's Metroplex. It's Metroplex, which has been turned into, by the Elliot Customs, into Devastator. And I thought it was, it's really cool, actually, if I go back, if you can see. So you can see here, in the images, he's obviously created it, his head, and scaled it. I thought it looked very cool.
That's crazy. Good. Is it a combiner, or is it?
No. So he's taken a Generations Metroplex and then retooled it.
With like kids, I'm guessing they're like kids construct. Yeah, they're kids construction toys. I can tell by the wheels.
Yeah.
Not saying that's a bad thing. I've done that before.
But it just looks, as you were saying, Nathan, you think this guy's coming on leaps and bounds as well. But this
I think he surpassed me.
Yeah, Scania truck, though, as you said, yeah.
I think he's almost surpassed me as well.
He's doing stuff like that. I couldn't do stuff like that, but he's surpassed me. I can do simple That's modifications. Crazy. But I like the idea of that, because I've always liked the idea of Devastator being absolutely gigantic.
That would be technically it's the same sort of size as Toy World Constructor, isn't it?
That's it doesn't transform.
No. It doesn't really. It would transform into Metroplex, but it doesn't really
That's going to be the size of Scorponok, what means it's going to be huge and amazing. Yeah,
it's just another repaint, because if you look at...
It's a heavy repaint. It's a heavy retool as well.
So I suppose if you compare this to the third-party Toy World's Devastator or Constructor, it's going to be much more secure.
Yeah, because it's all one piece. It's not separate parts. Like
exactly,
none of those arms are separate pieces. They're all just the robots have just been attached to them.
So yeah. So Constructor, not so much. It doesn't have the issues. But if you look at I've had so many frustrations with their version of Bruticus. It just comes unpegged in certain places. It's nothing to do with it. It's just the way it's designed, and I get frustrated. I actually put Bruticus up for sale just because I got frustrated with it. It's a lovely figure. And it poses really well. I mean, I've got him up top here, and he's with his helicopter mode right at the top here, gun sticking out like in his, with Vortex leaning down, trying to spin off all those drones that he did in Revenge of Bruticus. But I just find it frustrating. So my camera's now fucked. There we go. But
surprisingly, no one's done that idea before. You got to think, because people like the idea of Devastator being huge. But the Combiner Wars one is huge, but he's pose limited.
Mm. Well, I suppose you could look at. So Nathan, do you think there's any other Titans you would merge into other Combiners or other things?
It depends on the size. Because the only one I really think of is what you call him? I just Devastator. He's the only one who's a Combiner who's meant to be huge. Mm. The only one I could actually see you doing is. Oh, the Predaking.
Mm.
A Predaking one would be really nice to do, because again, he's meant to be massive. So, and people have issues with the official one. I think I remember.
Is there anything you've seen?
The Keel Predaking is quite cool. They changed quite a bit. The hands are better. The wings and
I heard that was he's a lot better. Yeah.
Is there anything you've seen anything you've wanted to do but you haven't attempted yet because you just haven't quite bottomed it out yet?
Yes, I want to do the last, well, I would say not the last, but the next of the Spark Bots, what is Fizzle. Mm-hmm. But to make him, I have to get a Power of the Primes Beachcomber, and he's not cheap anymore.
Well,
for some reason, he went, he's like 20, 30 quid. He's shot up in price. He's not impossible to get.
Does he have to be a complete?
I saw something about that, actually, on Facebook group.
I don't care if it's complete, because I'm making a custom, so...
The condition of it,
doesn't matter. I'll be modifying it. I can easily fix the problem, can't I?
Well, if there are any of our 200 followers who have a Power of the Primes Beachcomber and would like to part ways with
knackered,
it.
If someone's knackered that figure, I would love to know how.
You know, give it to
kids.
Like, how have you knackered it?
Kids, the wall test. How,
yeah.
Oh, look, I'm never having
children
kids.
Children find a way.
Do you know what, Daddy? It doesn't survive a microwave.
But no, I don't. If a
look, Daddy,
got...
look, Daddy, melted prime.
I'll show you a dead prime. Proper, it's a proper. Here's an actual dead Optimus. Here you go.
That's it. Super yeah, Optimus.
So, one final question for you, Nathan. Would you ever consider going, dropping down to obviously the best class, which is Legends class? And would you ever do a Masterpiece? So, would you break out of Chug?
Someone paid me enough. I don't do Masterpiece.
Would you not
Masterpiece.
Want to experiment with Legends?
No. Again, it depends on who wants it. Because I only collect Autobot Chug. I don't collect anything else. But if someone pays me to do it, I will. Like, I've got a guy who wants me to do some G1 customs. So
you say you do a lot of the customs for yourself, and if someone's willing to pay for a
figure, then I'll just have to tell him. If it's the first person, I'll just tell him it's a massive learning curve, so it's your funeral.
At least you're honest.
Well, I actually do have one masterpiece, and it's Blue Streak. I bought him in America for no reason. I actually like it, and now it's just the dustiest thing in the world. That and then the
which version Blue Streak is it? Because I know there's like 6 or 7 or 10.
I don't know. It's the actual Hasbro version. I got it in Toys R Us before they shut down in America.
Oh, well, the G1 version or the MP version? Sorry,
MP.
MP. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Before they did everything.
Okay, that would have been the original Streak, I think, in close.
Yeah, and I remember he had an issue. One of the parts is like molded backwards. So I had to cut it out with a knife in America.
Oh, I didn't notice that. I sold mine a while back, but
you won't notice it unless you have it. The foot, there's a part on the foot what just didn't let it on mine. It didn't let the foot come back. So
I had Streak and then Blue Streak and then Silver Streak, and I've got rid of Streak because I've got the 2 version.
I've
still got a Silver Streak and Blue Streak, but it's interesting. That.
Come here, you bugger. That one.
Yeah, that's the original Streak.
He's very dusty, Christ.
Oh, wow.
You didn't see that.
I thought that he was just in a matte colour.
It's like he could automatically give you asthma just by looking at
him. What's about that?
He's always been to Japan. He survived a volcano eruption.
If I can find the issue. Yeah, there it is. It was this part here. I can't see my own camera. I've got to see this Jamie's face.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
It's a good piece.
I know. I know
you're lucky,
I mean.
Lucky man.
Though. Yeah, it was... there we go. There. It's actually... not the right piece.
Ah, I know what you mean. It used to get stuck.
No, that's not. It's not that. It's actually not the right piece. It's literally the same piece on both feet.
Oh wow. Okay.
Oh yeah.
So I took a knife to it and cut it off. When you're in America,
Transformer.
When you're in America, you're in a hotel, and all you have is a kitchen knife. You just sort it.
many a man have said that, but that I think. Probably conclude it for tonight. Listen, Nathan, thank you so much for coming on. It's been an absolute pleasure. We've been massive fans since day one, and you'll continue to go from strength to strength.
Do you want to give a shout out to your YouTube channel at all, Nathan, or your Twitter feed?
This is where I don't remember anything.
Cluttered Desk.
Cluttered Desk. Just put it in the description, you'll find it.
Or just head to, if you can't find it, go to Transformers UK, the Facebook group, and you will find him there, because he often posts there, and we're quite lucky to have him there posting away.
Like recently, I'm posting all the images of the new Takara images of all the figures sort of coming out.
Yes, you did, and you posted Run Amok.
I found the website what lists them early.
Yes, and I saw that. They were good photos as well. Good descriptions. Right, next week we'll have Zort Rider on, who you may know from Zort Rider, and Rudy Zazoo from Rudy Zazoo. They're part of Figure Force, one of my favourite areas of the internet to go to. So I'm really looking forward to next week. Zort Rider.
It's not a pitch. He is actually a genuine fan of these guys.
Yeah, well, a lot of people will know.
Paul's
got a semi right now, everyone.
All truth, all the time.
Indeed. That's it. Something to end.
Hopefully, he'll get a detached once he's got enough money.
I wonder if Lex is trying to talk.
See, I cleaned it up.
Thank you. Brilliant. How can you unmute yourself?
Superpowers.
Right, so next week we have two amazing YouTubers, and they're going to talk about a really great day we're going to be part of. It's called Bots at Home. I can't wait for that. Nathan, thank you so much. If you go on to Facebook, you can find us at Transformers UK. If you go on to YouTube, search for the Transformers Show. Thank you to my co-hosts. I'm going to end it now. Goodbye, everyone.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Do you want to stop recording?
No.
Yes. There's the show. We are fucked. This time, okay?
Let's
try again tomorrow.
Okay, 3, 2. Transformers the UK show.
Come on, you
podcast. You're a podcast.
Transformers Hello. Podcast.
No, it's not podcast. It's show now.
Or is it just Transformers
show? Show? Are we?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, we'll save that for the thing.
Right, 3, 2, 1, go.